What's up, you guys? Such a Boss here, and today is the HLSL results. And right now, I'll talk about the R-Truth versus Gulak with 24 Hour Championship. Take away Sodge from the past. Past Sodge here, and today, WWE got some new matches added for HLSL. So right now, let's talk about the 24 Hour Championship match. Just got added.
Now is R-Truth versus Drew Gulak for the 24 Hour Championship, the kickoff show. It's going to be R-Truth winning this. Everyone knows that. R-Truth is super silly. Don't care for Gulak. I care for him a little bit, but not my favorite wrestler of all time. He's fun to watch. But still, it's going to be R-Truth. R-Truth is going to retain his title, and he's going to get his 24/7 I-95 South. WWE 24 Championship. So I'm excited for R-Truth to win it tonight. Also, guys, before I let Todd from the future talk to us, I'm really excited to see what's going to happen tonight. But mostly it's Sasha Banks match. See, got this right here, so I can showcase that in the video. But here it is. Okay, Sasha from the future. Here he comes. 1, 2, 3.
This match, it was a typical standard R-Truth match. R-Truth won. Fought for a little bit. Easy 1, 2, 3 fight truth. So typically when the belt back, so it's pretty easy. Little Jimmy's involved. And it was okay. Not my favorite.
For this is the Hurt. Is Slapjack and Retribution. Because I really like to see a title change for Retribution. Because Retribution is one of the top heels in WWE. And I really want to see them with a title. It'd be cool with the United States title to see them as a group. So I'm going with Slapjack by winning by disqualification or something like that. Also, I forgot it's Hell in a Cell. I gotta change my punishment predictions to 2 matches wrong. I'm doing that this 1 to 3, I'm so sorry. It makes sense, because I'll put my body through heck. If I get 2 matches wrong now, I have to do the 80s workout class.
A little bit of sacrifices right here. It's Bobby Lashley for Slapjack for the US title. I thought Slapjack could just win by disqualification to show some pain for Shibisha. I didn't want him to win the title, obviously, but I chose him. And also put a clip of me predicting this match. This match is The Miz vs. Otis for the Money in the Bank Championship contract. I thought this match was beautifully done. Miz had back and forth moves. I really like that. Everyone's fair game in that match. Otis looked pretty strong. The Miz looked awesome. I feel like, so Tucker literally turned on Otis, hit him with a briefcase. And that's how The Miz got 1, 2, 3 and he won it. I thought this match was really fun. I really appreciated how everything was in the match. Not my favorite match on the card, but it was still pretty interesting. I really appreciated it. So The Miz has a new opportunity to get a championship opportunity. Let's go. Right here we have Jeff Hardy versus Elias. I got this one wrong because Elias won. Just because Jeff Hardy disqualified himself by hitting Elias with a guitar. I thought this was kind of interesting because I love Jeff Hardy. I love everything we can do in the ring. I really appreciate Elias, too. Elias did a really good job. I really appreciate what both men can do, and I really love everything with the WWE. What a good match. Has to be one of the biggest upsets of the night, in my opinion. This is an incredible cage match. This is Drew McIntyre versus Randy Orton inside the cage. This match was phenomenal. It's all over the place. I really liked it. A lot of weapons were being used. I really appreciated what Randy can do, the mind games. I think how Randy literally climbed up. My favorite part of the match was when Randy climbed up from the cage. Drew McIntyre was climbing down off the cage with him. All of a sudden, McIntyre got shoved off. McIntyre couldn't get up on his feet. And then McIntyre got into the ring, RKO out of nowhere, Claymore's in the ring, and Drew McIntyre lost his title. I was really disappointed on this match. I was not expecting Randy Orton to get the belt. It was crazy, man. I love every single moment of this match. And it was beautiful. Beautiful what WWE can do with the storytelling. This is a really good match. Probably one of my favorites of the year. Really great match. Reigns versus Jey Uso. This match was horrible in the last Mercedes match. I thought maybe more weapons going to be involved. This is not my favorite match on the card. But Jey Uso only brought in leather strap and a couple chair shots. That's about it. And it was horrible. It was really horrible. And then all of a sudden, all the people show up around the ringside. It was okay. Not my favorite. It was not that special. It was one of those matches like we're really hyped for, like, for the eye for an eye, but it was not that good. It was just like that. It was horrible. Worst Roman Reigns match of 2020, and not my favorite. I don't really like what they did with the match. I thought it was okay, but not my favorite. I really appreciate what they could do last time they fought together, but in the cage, it looked pretty silly. It looked pretty stupid, too. So I like Roman Reigns. I know he's a really good opponent, but that match was a little bit too silly for me. I didn't really like it. Sasha Banks vs. Bayley inside the HSL match for SmackDown Women's Championship. This match was a beautiful match. It has to be my favorite match on the card of the night. I really like how Sasha Banks could defeat Bayley. It was everywhere. We had a lot of weapons tossed in, like ladder at one point, like a ladder table. We had Banks flying everywhere, Banks getting injured. At one point, I think Bayley injured Sasha's neck. I really appreciated what Sasha Banks could do in the ring. I love her white attire. I wish she had a little element of blue in it, not the silver, by the way. It's still kind of cool, though, that way. This match was incredible. This match was incredible for all that we can do, man. This is one of the matches we've been dying to see for a very long time. And I got this one right. Sasha Banks won the SmackDown Women's Championship from Bayley. This match is incredible. These two have a beautiful feud together from NXT, their friendship, and then now they're singles run together. I think it's cool. I want to see more matches like this on the card in the future. I really appreciated Sasha Banks winning the championship. What a match. At the end of the day, I feel like this match is a very, very strong match on the card. I really appreciated it with all the movesets in the ring. I think this is a sweet match. All the matches were pretty good. But this one was a really classic match, in my opinion. I love this women's match, and I'm really proud of what the Women's Revolution can do. I really appreciate it of WWE and the storytelling. This match was incredible. You gotta check this one out. I'm not gonna spoil what happened down in there. But Sasha won.
Right here, where I changed the matches, okay? To two.
Okay, guys, at the end of the day, I really rate Agent of the Cell a solid 9 out of 10 because some of the matches were kind of sloppy, but my favorite match by far has to be Sasha and Bayley, but other than that, it was a really good pay-per-view overall. I really appreciated it with everything they can do, and so I'm going to end the video now, so if you guys do like and subscribe, such a boss, more videos like this in the future, but I gotta do the 80s workout. So that video will be coming out soon, so I do not know when, probably after Halloween, okay? After Halloween, this video.
Okay, guys, we have Hurt Business versus Retribution. We have Bobby Lashley versus Slapjack from the United States Championship. This is Sod from the future. We just watched Sasha Banks just conquer Bayley tonight. What an amazing match that was. Talk about that tomorrow morning. But right now, let's talk about the Bobby Lashley versus Slapjack for the U.S. title.
Official rules. I'm putting my body and my mind through heck. Two matches, baby. Woo!